Well, I'm just gonna give it up now. Lost all ambition.
And what's tomorrow? Tomorrow's a time trial, isn't it?
Yeah, tomorrow's a time trial.
What about that? How will you do in that?
I don't know. It depends if the boss wants me to ride for... Because I'm 12th just now, and I can move up to 10th place if I ride well. And if he wants me to ride at my maximum or what, it depends on him.
Does it really?
Yeah. Right, eventually it all comes down to depending on me, but... if I can beat the other two guys, it's another story. It might not be worth it. I may not have enough strength left. It's difficult to say.
And then the last day is the run into Paris.
Yeah, and the last day is the kind of big day. You come past the Eiffel Tower. It's a kind of real bit of Paris. Otherwise, riding on the Champs-Élysées, it doesn't impress you because you're going so fast that you don't see the time going faster. You're just going to have to count down the laps. But the big thing about going to Paris is when you ride past the Eiffel Tower for me. It's impressive.
So although you're being quite philosophical about it now, that's the point at which you'll mind not having done particularly well this year.
Already I know that I haven't done well. So I'm disappointed with myself, with the guys in the team, and a lot of little small things that kind of hold the performance together or make sure that you can do something. And I can look back and see what's wrong. And next year I won't do it wrong. Be another story.
In Paris, Eno wins his fifth tour, although many say his American number two, Le Monde, deliberately held back to ensure the Frenchman's victory. Millar finishes 11th, but there's more of the season to come.
Well, this year was like bad news when I went to the tour. I rode maybe too many races, or I definitely rode too many races. I wanted to try and ride all the races at the beginning of the year to kind of prove to the other guys and to the team that I could ride the other races. And I was going okay in them, but I wasn't winning it. I haven't won any of them, and I was disappointed. And then I went to Tour of Spain and should have won, and I didn't. And that kind of cracked me up a bit. And I left a lot of reserves there.
And was that your fault, that you didn't win the Tour of Spain?
No, it was Berlon's fault. The team manager's fault that I lost. Because everybody was there knew I was... They all knew I should have won. Berlon knows I should have won when he thinks about it, but it's his fault. He can't do anything about it now.
Je ne voulais pas qu'il fasse le Tour d'Espagne. Moi, je ne voulais pas. Il a voulu faire le Tour d'Espagne et pour le Tour de France, il était un peu fatigué et il n'a pas fait les résultats, les mêmes résultats que l'année avant. C'est tout. Robert Millar, je le sais, ne pouvait pas supporter deux grands tours. Et en plus, le Tour d'Espagne avait été très difficile. Très, très, très difficile pour lui. C'est pour ça que dans le Tour de France, il n'était pas au plus haut niveau.
Robert Millar ve como la amenaza de Pacho se cierne sobre su liderazgo. En 16 kilómetros, el colombiano...
3 days from the end of the Tour of Spain, Millar is 6.25 minutes ahead of the main pack. He's wearing the leader's yellow jersey for the 8th successive day and seems set to be the first British rider to win a major European tour. But with 2 days to go, he punctures in bad weather at the bottom of a climb. Two Spanish riders take advantage of his problems and surge ahead.
En el descenso, a tumba abierta, Perico termina lo iniciado en la subida. Rompe con sus compañeros en la trepada y se va a tumba abierta a la caza y captura de Recio, con el que logra enlazar antes de Guadarrama.
The two Spaniards, Delgado and Recio, even though they ride for different teams, agree to help each other to try to whittle away Miller's massive lead. They get so far ahead, they're out of sight of the main bunch.
Mientras tanto, Millar tranquilo viaja.
Meanwhile, Millar catches the bunch after his wheel change. But he has no idea how far ahead the two Spaniards are. he is happy to stay with the riders who he thinks are his nearest challengers. And extraordinarily, no one tells him he's in trouble.
Y más perfecta entre los dos extraordinarios ciclistas.
Finally, the Peugeot team car comes up, and Bernard tells Miller the two Spaniards have wiped out his overall lead. But it's too late for Miller to attack, and he gets no help from the others, who are content to sacrifice their own chances in the interest of a Spanish victory.
Il y a eu surtout une faillite de gens qui ont fait une trahison, qui nous ont trahis. Des gens qui devaient nous aider, qui nous ont trahis. Un point, c'est tout, et c'est surtout ce que je condamne.
Et c'est qui, ces gens?
Je n'ai pas à dévoiler ici qui c'est. Robert Millar le sait, moi-même je le sais, et il sait très bien que c'est pas une faillite de l'équipe, ni de moi-même, puisque toutes les précautions étaient prises, parce que nous savions que ce serait difficile, très difficile, mais tout était mis en œuvre pour que Robert puisse gagner. Et nous avons été... Il y a des gens qui n'ont pas été corrects, c'est tout.
Miller felt that the financial approaches to other riders for support were not made early enough, and that's why he lost.
It's kind of common knowledge in Europe that other teams can be bought to help you in certain races if your team gets into trouble. It's up to the director sportif to deal with these kind of matters, because it'd be a bit hard for me to go and talk with their director sportif to try and get their team to ride. It's not my level. It's between the managers, roughly. And they should. It's up to him to realise what the right time is to do his job.
Mais il faut pas non plus avoir l'impression d'être des gens qui gaspillent l'argent.
Mais si on veut trouver assistance de les gens d'autres équipes, il faut payer, n'est-ce pas?
Si on veut, oui. Ou trouver d'autres arrangements. Mais ce n'était pas un problème.
Et ça, c'est accepté.
Puisque c'était fait.
En un logique geste de compagnerisme,
Berland's attempt to buy support from other teams had failed. In the closing stages of the tour, the Spanish plan succeeds and Delgado goes on to win. But for teammate Alan Piper, it still leaves open the question of Miller's ability as a leader.
Robert hasn't got the strength as a human being to control other people. He's more likely to say, well, let them do what they do and I'll do what I do. And that's not the way to work it. I've told him before, but it's not in his nature, and I understand that. But somebody has to take the initiative. And if it's not the leader of the team, then it has to be a rider. And if you haven't got either, well, then you've got nothing.
But is it possible for Robert to contemplate greatness if he hasn't got that in him? Can he go on and be one of the greats?
Yeah, but it's difficult. Because he can't find loyalty like Sean Yates and myself. We ride for him through him. We ride for Robert because we're loyal to him, because he's our friend. Because we think a lot of him, not because he's Robert Millar, the Scotsman who won the jersey last year, and we won a lot of money from him. That's not the reason. Look, this year he didn't win the climbers jersey, and Sean and I have missed a hell of a lot of criteriums that we got last year through Robert, but we didn't say anything to him because we know he's only human, and he can't do the job that he unless everything's right.